So as I was telling, at P what happens, there will be simultaneous crystallization of austerite and enstatite, and what happens, austerite will react with liquid to produce enstatite. The early formed austerite that is being formed from 1 to P, from 1 to P what will happen, only austerite is forming, as I have written here, at 1 there will be austerite plus liquid. From 1 to P there is only crystallization of austerite from the magma. When it reaches P what happens, there will be formation of austerite as well as enstatite from magma, and there will be remaining liquid. This liquid will react with the early formed austerite to again produce enstatite. That means at point P, how many number of phases are there? 3 phases are there, as I have told. Degree of freedom will be become 0, invariant, and all this again. Yes, at point P, the enstatite which is forming, the enstatite which is crystallizing, right? The enstatite which is crystallizing, that is by two methods, that is by two processes, you can say, directly from magma. As I have told, there are simultaneous crystallization of austerite and enstatite. So enstatite is produced directly from magmatic crystallization, and the second process is by the reaction of austerite with remaining liquid, by the reaction between austerite and remaining liquid. Okay, so there will be at point P, what are the processes? Crystallization of austerite, as it is moving in this austerite field, P is the common point between austerite field and enstatite field. So at point P, austerite will be crystallizing, enstatite will be crystallizing from magma, and austerite reacts with magma to produce enstatite. Okay, so enstatite is producing by two methods or two means. One is directly from magmatic crystallization, another one is due to reaction between austerite and liquid. The austerite is forming also at P point, the austerite is also crystallizing and it is also reacting with the magma. Okay, so what happens in between this austerite and liquid, reaction between this austerite and liquid, enstatite will form. So what will happen, either austerite will finish or the liquid will finish. Because if the magma has to move from P to the next points or towards eutectic, if, as I have told, this is temporary eutectic, okay, this is not permanent, that means there is a chance to move forward, when there will be end of this phase, end of this austerite, when there will be end of this austerite, then only magma can move. Okay, if there is end of this liquid, then we are getting directly austerite and enstatite as end product, then we will be getting austerite and enstatite as end product. I think all of you got that. If liquid will be ended, if liquid will be finished, because it is reaction between austerite and liquid. Okay, if liquid will be finished, then what will happen? The end point will be austerite and enstatite. If austerite will be finished, then there will be liquid and enstatite. Okay, so if there is liquid and enstatite, then we will move to the next phase. Part of this diagram. Next curve of this diagram, let's say, I'm writing it here. If austerite will finish, okay, let's say this austerite will finish, then what happens? Number of phase becomes 2. How? One is enstatite solid, another one is liquid. So if Number of edges is 2, number of component is 2 because of we are taking binary, number of component is 2, number of edges is 2, one is inserted, another one is liquid, degree of freedom becomes 1, 2 plus 1 minus 2, so that is 1. So then only magma will start to move from P to E, okay. And as I have told, when there is austerite plus instratite, when there is austerite plus instratite, that means at this case liquid will finish, at this case liquid will finish. If liquid will finish, the end point will be austerite and instratite. That means in the system there is not sufficient liquid to convert the whole of the austerite to instratite. That's why we are finding austerite and instratite as end point. Okay. If I'm repeating the sentence again, if the liquid is not enough, if there is not enough liquid so that it can convert the whole of the austerite to instratite, then what will happen? Liquid will finish and we are getting the end point or the result as austerite plus instratite. If there is so much of liquid so that it can end the austerite. If there is so much of liquid so that it will alter or it will react with austerite to produce instratite, it will react with whole of the austerite to produce instratite, and still there is some remaining melt, then what will happen? It will move towards the next diagram or next part of the phase diagram, because the phase becomes 2 then, so degree of freedom becomes 1, so it will start migrating towards the next part. Okay, so now the question comes, when austerite will end, when liquid will end. Okay, now the question is, when austerite will come, when austerite will end and when liquid will end. I think all of you got the result. If austerite will end, that will migrate to next. If liquid will end, we will get austerite and instratite as end point. So now the question is, what is the situation or when this situation is obtained, when austerite will be ended or when liquid will be ended. So that's why I have marked a dotted line here. I have marked this line and in between that, below that I have written here instratite. So this line suggests that, this line is suggesting that if I am taking any composition before this line, if I am taking any composition before this line, then what will happen? We'll find austerite plus instratite as end product. This is the field, right? This is the field of austerite plus instratite. This is entirely solid phase. This is the entirely solid part. As I have told, this is liquidus and this is solidus. This is the solidus. Okay. And this above part is liquidus. So here you will find austerite solid and instratite solid. Okay. So if this is the line, this line is marking that composition, this line is marking that boundary before which, if we will take composition, any composition, that will end with austerite and instratite, that will end with solid of austerite and instratite. If I am taking a composition here, let's say X2, is a composition here, what will happen? It will go and touch here, so at this point what will happen? This is again the field of austerite, so what will happen? Austerite will produce, then along with austerite there will be liquid. So there are two phases. Again, if there are two phases, degree of freedom becomes 1. So then it start to migrate towards P. At P what happens? There will be formation of austerite, there will be formation of instratite, and there will be reaction between early formed austerite and liquid to form instratite, At this point, at this case, for this X2 composition, what will happen? The austerite will be finished. For this composition X2, which is after this line, which is here, that suggests that at peritectic hostellate will be end of and we will find liquid, remaining liquid and enstatite. Then it will migrate towards next point. Okay. I hope all of you get this point. Before P for X1 and X2, let's say this is X1, this is X2, process is same. When it will toss this curve, it will form hostellate and there will be remaining liquid. So when there will be hostellate and liquid, that means two phases. When there will be two phases, components are two, phases are two, 2 minus 2 cancel, degree of freedom becomes 1. It will start moving towards P. At P what happens? There will be a formation of hostellate, there will be a formation of enstatite, there will be some remaining liquid. This remaining liquid will react with hostellate to form enstatite again. Okay, so enstatite is produced by two means, directly from magmatic crystallization and by the reaction between hostellate and liquid. Directly from magmatic crystallization and by the reaction between hostellate and liquid. So what happens? Either hostellate will finish or this liquid will finish. Either hostellate will finish or this magma will finish. So that is defined by this line. If I am taking any composition before it, that means liquid will finish because hostellate is in excess than liquid. If I am taking beyond this line, if I am taking any composition beyond this line, that means hostellate is lesser as compared to the liquid. So hostellate will finish and there will be some remaining liquid. If there is some remaining liquid, what will happen? At point P, as I have told, there will be enstatite and liquid. Okay, so there are two phases. If number of phases is 2, component is 2, the degree of freedom becomes 1, then the magma will move towards E. Right? Then at E what happens? As I have told, E is the eutectic. Eutectic means here we will get enstatite. At this curve, from P to E, there will be enstatite plus liquid, as it is written here. From P to E, you will get enstatite plus liquid. At eutectic, what you will get? Enstatite plus quartz, because this eutectic is common point between liquidus of enstatite and liquidus of quartz. This is your liquidus of quartz. Okay. So, we will get enstatite plus quartz plus liquid. Enstatite in solid, quartz in solid plus liquid. So there are three phases again, 1, 2, 3, number of phases will be 3. If number of phases will be 3, component is 2 plus 1, 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Degree of freedom becomes 0, that will become invariant. All of the magma will be end up here producing enstatite plus quartz as end member. When we'll get enstatite plus quartz as end member? If the magma move from P to E, if the magma is moving ahead of P, ahead of this peritectic, this reaction point or this temporary eutectic point, then only we are getting enstatite plus quartz. Okay, if the magma will reach eutectic, then only we can get quartz. If the magma will be ended at P, we will get hostellate plus enstatite. Then, which is the factor that defines if magma is ended at P or it will move to E? This line. If we are taking composition before this line, then magma will end at P. If I am taking composition after this line, the magma will end at E, producing enstatite plus quartz. If it is ended at P, it will form hostellate plus enstatite. But I have taken hostellate plus quartz as the end point. Starting composition X1 is defined as hostellate 90 and quartz 10. That means magnesium silicate, magnesium silicate composition is 90 and pure Si2 composition is 10. X2 is similarly like let's say this is 70-30. Let's say this is hostellate 65, let's say first rate 65, and quads 35. Okay, so at this point you will get first rate 65 and quads 35. This is the composition of H2. Okay, at this point we are getting insertite plus quad. So we are taking fosterite and quads. We are taking composition between fosterite and quads. But we are getting either fosterite plus insertite or getting insertite plus quads. That means we have taken some different composition, that is magnesium silicate and pure silica. But we are getting magnesium silicate, but that is pyroxene. Pyroxene, we have taken olivine and quads, but we are getting either olivine plus pyroxene or we will get pyroxene plus quads. We are taking undersaturated and oversaturated at the initial composition, but either we will get undersaturated and saturated or we will get saturated and oversaturated. In no field we are getting undersaturated and oversaturated. So this is the cause why we are not finding quads in olivine rich rocks, or we are not finding olivine in silicic rocks or felsic rocks, or which are rich in quads. Similarly, if I'll take here leucite and quads. So I hope all of you got this point. I am taking another composition here, let's say X3 here. What will happen if I will take X3 here? It will go to, as I have told, same case here, there will be number of phases will be 1, that is entirely liquid, so degree of freedom become 2. But as there is no solid, there is only one phase, that is liquid, we cannot change the composition. Okay. So keeping constant composition, temperature will decrease. When it will touch here, at this temperature, at first quads will form. Let's say this composition is quads 90 and fosterite 10. This composition is quads 90 and fosterite 10. Then what will happen? At first quads will form. Then it will, quads will form means number of phase will become 2. One is quad solid, second one is liquid. So if number of phases are 2, degree of freedom becomes 1. 2 plus 1 minus 2, that means 1. So degree of freedom becomes 1, that means it will move towards eutectic. At eutectic, what happens? There will be simultaneous crystallization of quads and insertite, and there will be some liquid. So number of phase becomes 3. If number of phase becomes 3, component is 2, 2 plus 1, 3, minus 3 is equal to 0. So degree of freedom becomes 0 at eutectic point, that is the invariant point. No crystallization, there will be no movement of magma. Okay, no movement of magma means the temperature composition system, right? This is the temperature axis, this is the composition axis. This point will not move. The temperature composition point, that will not move, that will be remain fixed at this point. And as I have told, this eutectic point, it is having some fixed composition and fixed temperature. Right, for all systems. So why it is incongruent? Because we have taken fosterite and quads, but we are getting fosterite plus insertite, or we are getting insertite plus quads. So this is incongruent. Similarly, if we talk about melting, what will happen? Let me erase this diagram so that you can better understand. Let me show you. This is our fosterite, this is quartz. It's like this, and it will be like this. Okay. This is your phosphatite plus enstatite. Enstatite plus liquid. This is phosphatite plus liquid. This is enstatite plus quartz. Quartz plus liquid. This is my enstatite. Okay. So, okay. Now we are talking about melting. So in previous case, I am talking about incongruent crystallization. I have told you how it is, why it is incongruent, because initial composition is different, final composition is different. Then talking about melting, let's say I am taking a composition here. I am taking a composition here. That means, let's say phosphatite 70, phosphatite 70 and quartz 30. Okay, phosphatite 70 and quartz 30. As I have told, phosphatite is 100% here and quartz is 100% here. So quartz is decreasing in this direction, phosphatite is decreasing in this direction. So this point is phosphatite 70 and quartz 30. Okay, so here what you are getting? Enstatite plus quartz. This is the field of enstatite plus quartz, right? The composition will be phosphatite and quartz, but the final compounds are enstatite and quartz, right? So what happens? You are taking enstatite plus quartz, then what happens? You are increasing its temperature. Temperature is increased in this direction, right? Because we are melting. In case of crystallization, we are decreasing temperature. In case of melting, we are increasing the temperature. So we will increase the temperature. When it touches this temperature, what is this? Eutectic point, right? This is the eutectic point. So when it touches this eutectic point, what will happen? This eutectic temperature, this line means, this is a straight line, that means this is the temperature of eutectic point. That is the temperature of eutectic point. The temperature from this point to this point, if I am increasing, it will be in solid phase. When it touches this point TE, that means it will move directly to eutectic, right? I am increasing this temperature, means it is the same temperature, eutectic temperature. At eutectic temperature, what will happen? At eutectic point, what will happen? There will be enstatite solid plus quartz solid plus liquid. And this liquid is coming from quartz. At first, quartz will remove, because quartz is the low temperature mineral. And during the crystallization also, quartz is formed at the end. So when it reaches at this point, at this temperature, eutectic temperature, at first quartz will move towards liquid. At first quartz will move to the liquid form. That means SiO2 is going to the melt phase. SiO2 is moving towards liquid. Then what will happen? If there is SiO2 in melt phase, enstatite solid plus quartz solid, that means number of phases are 3, enstatite, quartz and melt. Number of phases are 3. So as I have told you, P plus F will be equal to C plus 1. So F will be equal to C plus 1 minus P. This is my phase rule. Components are 2. 2 plus 1, 3 minus 3. That will become 0. So at eutectic point, that is invariant. So there is no movement. When there will be a movement? When quartz will be finished. When the whole amount of quartz in solid form will change to liquid form, or will converted into melt, as well as there is production of enstatite. Okay, as well as there is production of melt of enstatite. Why? Because this is the point of common crystallization. Right? Eutectic point is the common point for crystallization of both enstatite and quartz, right? So there will be enstatite solid, quartz solid as well as melt of enstatite and quartz. There will be enstatite and there will be silica in the melt. Enstatite is removing, enstatite is moving towards melt phase, quartz is also moving towards melt phase, right? So there are three phases, two solid and one melt. As I have told you during eutectic system, in liquid phase you cannot distinguish between what is enstatite, what is quartz. So you have to take it as a single phase, right? So number of phases are 3, degree of freedom becomes 0. So what will happen? As quartz is the low temperature mineral, at first quartz will be ended. Let me write it here so that you can better understand. At eutectic there will be enstatite solid plus quartz solid plus liquid. Then what will happen? Quartz will finish, because when there are three phases, degree of freedom becomes 0. At first what will happen? Quartz will finish, because that is the low temperature mineral, that is the low temperature mineral, that's why it will finish. Then what will happen? There will be enstatite plus liquid. So number of phases are now become 2, degree of freedom becomes 1. I am raising the temperature, okay? So what will happen? It will move like this, it will move towards this. Okay, degree of freedom become 1, I am raising the temperature, and as quartz is removing SiO2, is removing, enstatite is also removing SiO2, quartz is also removing SiO2, quartz is now completely vanished, so now talk about enstatite. If quartz will vanish, then only it will move to this phase, right? This is the condition when it is moving from E to P. Okay, this is the condition. When it will move from E to P, when entire quartz will finish and there will be enstatite plus liquid, then enstatite is removing SiO2 to the liquid. Enstatite is releasing SiO2 to the liquid, right? From E to P. This is the peritectic. At P what happens? There will be, because I am raising temperature, the composition moving towards posterite and temperature is increasing, right? So at P what happens? Enstatite will be forming liquid, and enstatite will release minus SiO2, enstatite minus SiO2 to form posterate, okay? There will be releasing of enstatite melt, and there will be reaction of, SiO2 is moving out of enstatite to produce posterate at point P, okay? From E to P, there will be production of enstatite melt. At E, there will be quartz plus enstatite plus melt, and this melt is producing both from quartz and enstatite. At first quartz will over, then there will be enstatite moving to liquid phase, then at point P what will happen? Enstatite will release SiO2 to become posterate, as well as enstatite is moving towards liquid form. So there are three phases. What is that? Enstatite solid, posterate solid plus liquid. So there are three phases. Degree of freedom again becomes 0. When there are three phases, 2 plus 1 minus 3, that means 0. So degree of freedom becomes 0. Again, it will become invariant. So it cannot move ahead from P until what? Until one of them will finish. So as I have taken the composition here, so what will happen? All enstatite will finish. Then it will produce posterate plus liquid. Okay, insert it is finished.